Welcome to the web tutorial on merging PSID records. To begin, let's go over what you can expect to learn. This tutorial has three sections. We'll start with an overview of the basic file structure of the PSID, followed by details about the most important merging or identifier variables. We'll then provide several examples of how to merge records, including merging individuals within a year across files, merging family-level information to individuals within a year, and merging individuals across years. A separate tutorial, Merging PSID Records Part 2, provides an example of merging families over time. Let's begin with an explanation of the file structure of the PSID. In each wave of the PSID, users are provided with two files, one with information on individuals and the other with information on family units. Individuals may enter or exit the study for a variety of reasons. Individuals enter by being born or adopted, by marrying or cohabiting with someone in the PSID, moving into a PSID household, or being part of a refresher sample. Individuals leave the study when they die, attrit, or if they divorce or move out of a PSID household, and they are not designated as followable. Individuals are part of a family unit, and though the individual does not change, the composition of families may change from wave to wave. The family level consists of family units. Possible changes to these family units include, but are not limited to, adult children splitting off from their parents' households and establishing their own economically independent family units, families combining by moving in together or expanding through marriage or cohabitation or childbirth, and families separating through relationship dissolution, divorce, or death. When PSID collects information on the reference person and spouse partner only, that information is most often included on the family file. Starting with the 2017 wave, the term reference person has replaced head. Please see the video tutorial, Introduction to the Panel Study of Income Dynamics, for more information about this change. Individuals are assigned identifier variables for the study and identifier variables for each wave. The unique ID for the study is made of two variables, one indicating their original 1968 family and the other indicating their number within that family or person number. In addition, each wave, each individual is assigned a wave-specific ID, one indicating their family unit in the current year, and the other indicating their sequence number within that family in that year. Like individuals, families also have a unique ID each wave. But the 1968 ID does not provide enough information to merge families over time. Let's take a look at these identifier variables. The PSID provides four key identifier variables which allow data users to define individuals and families in specific ways and across all waves of the study. The four IDs are the wave-specific family interview number and sequence number, and the 1968 ID and person number. The family interview ID number is assigned each year to families in the order in which they are interviewed for the core PSID in that wave. A sequence number is assigned to each person in a family in the order that they are listed on the family roster. To identify an individual in a specific year, you would use the family interview ID number in combination with the sequence number. The family interview ID number in combination with the sequence number is unique for each specific wave of data. Some statistical software programs let you specify two variables for merging. If you prefer to create a single ID for merging, you can multiply the family interview ID number by 1,000 and then add the sequence number for a specific year. Variable ER30001 is the 1968 family interview number, also called 68ID. This variable uniquely identifies each family and also indicates the original sample from which the family was drawn. That is, whether it's from an SRC random sample, the SEO low income oversample, or an immigrant refresher. Variable ER30002 is the person number for an individual. To identify the same individual across all waves, you would use the 1968 ID in combination with the person number. Again, to create a single ID, you can multiply the 68 ID by 1,000 and then add the person number so that each individual can be uniquely identified. The combination of the 68 ID and person number is the same across all waves in which an individual appears, so it can be used to link data for individuals across years. Note that an individual's person number may change from release to release as new information is collected about their relationship to others in the study. For the most accurate merges, we therefore recommend using the latest release of data. To summarize, there are two types of identifiers, family and individual, and two timeframes, yearly and crosswave. Depending on your unit of analysis and the waves of data you are analyzing, you may need to use more than one of these identifiers for your research. Let's review some examples. If you wanted to link family-level information to all individuals in the 2009 individual file, you would use the variable ER42002, the 2009 family interview number from the family file, with the variable ER34001, the 2009 family interview number from the individual file. Note that the data center will automatically make this merge for you if you include both family level and individual level variables in your data cart. Now suppose you wanted to link all individuals from the Disability and Use of Time Supplement in 2009 with the 2009 individual file. Then you would use the 2009 family interview number in combination with the 2009 sequence number, or variables ER34001 and ER34002 from the 2009 individual file, and variables DF1YRID and DF1SN from the 2009 Dust Flat file. If you wanted to link all individuals from the Disability and Use of Time Supplement in 2013 with the 2013 individual file, you would use the 2013 family interview number in combination with the 2013 sequence number from the 2013 individual file and the family interview number and sequence number from the 2013 Dust Flat file. Finally, we'll briefly discuss linking individuals and families over time. Let's begin with individuals. Individuals are linkable across waves through their cross-wave unique identifier. As described previously, a unique identifier can be created by multiplying the 1968 ID variable ER30001 by 1000 and adding their person number, variable ER30002. For example, to link all individuals in the 2011 individual file with individuals in the 2013 individual file, you could use as the link in both files the 1968 ID in combination with the person number. Analysts may also link families over time. However, the analyst must first decide on how to define a family and how to handle changes in family composition over time. Once the individuals that make up a family are identified in each year, those individuals, or some subset, can be linked over time. Part 2 of this tutorial provides some examples of linking families over time. This web tutorial was produced by Nora Insulera and Vicki Friedman in collaboration with the Michigan Center on the Demography of Aging, with funding from the National Institute on Aging. This ends the video tutorial on merging PSID records. Comments and questions may be sent to psidhelp@umich.edu.